Weren't spinning my bin, were you?
No, of course not, Dad. I just bought in the overnight crimes.
All right. Best of luck, Jack.
What with?
Promotion.
Same to you, Derek.
It might seem like a stab in the dark, Gov, but Liz Rawdon Stout's come up with the goods before. You asked to be kept informed. Of course, Jim Carver has always loved dressing up in women's clothes.
What?
You seem a bit preoccupied, Gov. Something on your mind?
I was just thinking.
About Jim Carver?
No, about myself. About being superintendent again.
You finished the application form, then?
Eventually. 16 boxes to fill in. Analytical thinking, I can't even say it, strategic perspective, delegation. I should have talked to you about that.
What's the time frame on this?
Well, Mr. Brownlow sent the application off to Area. They'll do the paper sift this week, and then hopefully in September, I'll be in the assessment centre.
I'm sure you will be. Has Derek Conway applied again?
What do you think?
Necktie.
Not going anywhere at the moment.
Huh? What's the problem?
It won't start.
Yeah, well, I gathered that. I meant what's wrong with it.
It'd be quicker if I told you what was still working.
This isn't the car that Roy Skye sold you, is it?
Yes.
What'd you buy this for?
It was cheap.
Yeah, I see why.
Well, so can I, now. Went like a dream when I test drove it.
Yeah, right.
What's he done to it?
Come on, Dave, you've seen Rod Skase drive. You should have guessed that he'd have knackered it.
It's got a full service history.
Yeah, yeah. And Skase never tampers with the evidence, does he?
Yes, at last!
Can I have that lift now?
No, I'm not going in this early. I'm going shopping and I might give the engine a tune-up.
The engine a tune-up? You've only got 3 hours, mate.
What are you going in for now, anyway?
It's Federation business. Got to see a colleague in CID.
Who?
Well, if you want to know, it's your favourite second-hand car dealer.
Rod? What about?
No, he wants me to give him some advice about the job. It's personal and confidential.
You'll tell me later.
Buy us a pint, will you?
See it too.
Set up.
Is there a problem, sir?
I'm making sure there isn't one, Stuart. I don't want the area inspection team finding any mistakes you and I have missed.
When are they coming?
Half an hour. DVU and CAD room first, but I've already been up there. They'll be down here after changeover. But don't think that lets you off the hook, because if I find so much as a comma out of place, I will personally crucify every custody officer and jailer who's been on duty this week.
Seems a bit harsh, sir.
I want the inspection team to be impressed, Stuart. I'm responsible for custody. I get marked down if there are any problems.
It's only an area inspection. It's no big deal.
Wrong, Stuart. For me, it's a very big deal.
But why?
I have my reasons.
Right. Well, go polish the keyholes then.
Good.
George, are you here?
Yeah, as requested.
You didn't get my message, then?
Saying what?
That I got it sorted, that I didn't need you after all.
Well, I've come in 2.5 hours early just to help you out.
Still, you're the Fed rep. It's part of the job, isn't it?
Oh, fine. Next time you want any help from me...
Excuse me, I've got an interview on this.
Thanks, pal.
Morning. Could you tell Mr. Brownlow we're here? Inspector Hornby and Sergeant Draper.
From?
We are the area inspection team.
Eagle Eye was a non-starter from the word go. I mean, long term, it simply didn't work.
Yeah, well, just ask the people on the Canley estate, the Cockcroft, the Larkmead, they all seem happy enough.
Yeah, for now, maybe, but you ask them in a month's time.
Oh, I will, Jack. It's part of the follow-up to my clampdown.
Your clampdown?
Well, we both know whose idea it was, don't we?
Sergeant Draper, it's not Linda Draper, is it?
Yes, that's right, sir.
Weren't you at university with Emma Standing?
Yes, we shared a flat together in our final year.
Oh. You still in touch?
Saw her last week to celebrate her promotion.
Well, Inspector already. Well, they get younger every year, don't they, Inspector?
They certainly do, sir.
I developed that strategy myself.
Yeah, but we set down the key objectives together.
No, you agreed them. I set them down.
You don't own them, Derek. I had as much right to use them on my application as you did.
Oh, rubbish. You're supposed to fill those boxes with genuine examples, not a load of...
I'd like to introduce you to my senior officers.
Morning.
Hello. Morning.
Good morning.
I'm so sorry. I don't know what happened. I just flushed it and the water came pouring out.
Don't worry about it. We've had problems with that toilet before.
Hey, I don't suppose you could leave the hatch open. I'm a little claustrophobic.
I'm not supposed to. Sorry.
Please. You won't hear another peep out of me.
You want a big guff?
This furniture's not in good condition, is it?
I haven't really thought about it.
Do you think there's enough chairs in here?
What for?
I don't know. It just says sufficient chairs here. This is the checklist that the area team are going to use when they inspect the late-term parade. Right, visual displays. They're all right, aren't they? What's behind that flip chart?
A couple of faces. What, do you want me to lose it?
No, leave it, because Rod Scarce might need it.
He's not in till 2.
He's coming in now. I need his help.
What for?
For the late-term parade. If anything goes wrong, I get the blame.
You do?
As crime manager, all the briefings are my responsibility. Even if it's just uniform deciding what car they're going to take.
Well, so if there aren't enough chairs, you get your knuckles wrapped?
No, it's not funny, Chris. My application's at area.
Right.
Now, the sergeant on the area inspection team is a governor's narc called Draper. And anything that she finds to criticise, she's going to pass on to her chum, A.C. Hicks.
And that's the end of your application?
No, that's not the worst of it, see. Derek Conway knew all about this Sergeant Draper, but he kept it to himself. So he's been around the nick this morning, making sure that he comes out of this inspection smelling of roses. So I want to make sure that this room and the parade are perfect.
Right.
Right, now, apart from the furniture, they'll be looking to see that the room's neat and tidy.
It's not good, is it?
TV, recorder.
20-inch screen, VHS remote control.
Blah, blah, blah. CID presence at briefing. Right, it's essential that we have some of our people here at 2 o'clock.
Well, they're all pretty busy.
So they should be, but I want some bodies here. Rod's already volunteered.
Have I? What for?
The DI will explain. And when you've finished, I want to see you.
Finish what? Cleaning. Get yourself a hoover.
How's it going, George?
Oh, yeah, I'll be fine. Once I've got some grub inside me, yeah.
I know what you mean.
Liz, what are you doing at 2 o'clock?
Digesting me lunch, why?
It's just that Meadows wants you in DIU.
What for?
We've got a couple of pen pushers here from area. They're going to give me marks out of 10 for the late term parade.
What's that going to do with Mr. Meadows?
Well, he's the crimes manager, isn't he? So it's all down to him, except he's delegated everything down to me now, which means I have to make sure the DIU is clean and tidy, and I have to get 3 DCs to turn up and look intelligent.
No chance.
Hello? Hey, George, yeah, what's up? I'm on a bus. I'm on a bus. Car's in the garage. Rod Scarce. Yeah, I'll get there as quick as I can. Yeah. Bye.
Thought you'd be keen to help out.
Rod Scarce must have known the start the motor was knackered. And they say the clutch is about to go any minute. I'm gonna kill him.
No need, Dave. You see, all we have to do is cock up the parade, and then the DCI will murder him.
So what do we do?
Well, we just make the place look a bit more lived in, that's all.
What, like it normally does?
Yeah, only worse. So we lose the flip chart, don't need the telly, all these chairs can go and...
Go where?
Briefing room, mate.
afternoon, sir.
June, just the person. Can you spare a minute?
Yeah.
In there.
Andrew, off to the late term parade?
Not today, Chris. I've got a meeting at the town hall.
But you ought to be there.
Well, I think June Ackland can cope.
It'd look bad without an inspector present.
Well, then drop in yourself, Chris. See what you've been missing.
We're both trying for superintendent.
Oh, you're trying again?
Well, it may seem a little over-optimistic to you, June, but I have heard encouraging noises from some friends.
Oh, would these be the friends with the funny handshakes?
Possibly. The point is, I have been told that things might go my way this time.
Great.
If it wasn't for Jack Meadows.
Eh?
They're not going to promote two chief inspectors from the same nick.
Who says? These friends of yours. I see, so it's uniform versus CID, just for a change.
And that's where you come in, June.
Who are they?
They're from area.
Yeah. Well, what are they doing here?
They're part of the area recruitment secondment exercise.
Well, what's that?
They check up on PCs in every nick in their patch. They're especially keen to quiz probations.
What about?
What you've been up to since you arrived, your best arrest, worst experience. I'd have your answers ready for me if I was you, Luke.
Yeah, I will, Tone. Thanks.
I thought you were duty sergeant, not June Ackland.
No, I'm cad today.
Well, can't you swap?
Why?
Well, June's a bit laid back for me. I need an authority figure, somebody who's going to make the troops sit up and take notice.
June! Have you got a moment?
Yes, sir.
Hi, June. June, I thought I might drop in on DIU, if that's all right with you.
Any particular reason?
No reason. Well, I know Inspector Monroe can't be with us today, so I thought I'd just drop in and, well, lend support.
That sounds as if you think I might need some help.
No, that's not what I meant.
Good.
But if they could be lively, you know, paying attention.
Everyone pays attention when I'm in charge, sir, despite what some people might think.
Sure, but perhaps if you had a word with, you know, gee them up a bit.
What, so that Mr. Meadows can get some brownie points?
He would appreciate a well-run parade.
I'll have to make sure he gets one then, won't I, sir?
Thanks, Jim. 5 minutes.
Right, would one of you like to tell me what's going on?
Do we have a choice?
Luke. Okay. There he is. Now's your chance, yeah? Come on in.
Hello, sir. PC Ashton.
Oh, yes? Did you want something?
Well, I thought I'd introduce myself. I gather you'll be looking for me later.
Will I?
Well, I'm a probationer. I arrived here about 10 months ago.
And I'm an inspector. I arrived here 2 hours ago. Now, what do you want, son?
Are you part of the area recruitment secondment exercise?
What's that?
I don't know, sir.
Area recruitment secondment exercise? A-R-S-E. What do those letters spell?
Oh, R.
I think someone's been a bit silly, don't you?
Everything okay, June?
Everything's gonna be just fine, sir.
For you.
We're full now.
Well, what's wrong with number two?
The bog's blocked. I'll call the surveyors department.
No chance of getting a plumber this year, I suppose. Was that asking too much?
I think it'll be sometime today.
Good.
Probably.
Michael Haslam.
Good as gold, but he is claustrophobic.
Really?
Hey, don't shut the hatch, please! Please!
Oh, yeah. So he is.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You're not funny, okay? You're not funny.
No,
don't do it again. You made me look like a pillock, Tone.
How could anyone do that, Luke? Right, we all here? I'd like to start off by reminding you about these street parties in Hambleton Green and Ellis Square. Now, that whole area is going to be closed.
Oh, sorry, Beth. Not late, what's that?
Well, only just, sir. Should I wait for anybody else?
DCI Meadows on his way, and Rod Skase should be here.
Well, what's going on?
There isn't some kind of joint operation tonight, is there, sir?
Well, it must be something big going on if the DCI's slumming it down here with us.
Yeah, all right, all right. As I said, Hambleton Green and Ellis Square area will be closed to traffic from 17:30 until midnight. We're not...
Sorry we're late. Sorry, mate. Just pretend we're not here.
I'll try, sir. We're not expecting any public
Perhaps
order
I should just explain that these two officers, they're from area. This is Inspector Hornby and Sergeant Draper. They're here to see how we run our parades at Sunhill. So just carry on as normal.
As normal, sir.
Yeah, got a problem with that, Dave?
No, sir.
Would you like to sit or stand?
I'll stand.
It's just as well, really.
What was that?
Well, there aren't any seats, sir.
As normal.
But there were half a dozen chairs here this morning. So where have they all gone?
I've got no idea, sir.
Well, hell, we'll sort that out later. Carry on, June.
Right, we're not expecting any public order problems. The normal licensing hours apply in all the pubs, and the Residents Association have promised to ensure that there won't be a repeat of last year's conga down Loftus Street.
Oh, you were lucky to catch me. I was just on my way. Well, I could make 4 o'clock, I suppose. OK, I'll see you then. Bye.
Careful, Rod!
Sorry, sir, I'm in a hurry.
Yeah, don't forget about those roadworks down there. And George and Michelle, you're in Sierra Oscar 2-1.
Rod, so where have you been?
Sorry, sir, I was on the phone.
Room for a small one?
Not really, no.
It's very cosy in here today.
Always is, isn't it, Rod?
Yeah, always.
How would you know?
Sarge, you're in the middle of assigning the mobile units.
Actually, I'd finished, sir.
I thought so. So, what's next?
Yes, Rod Skase has got some intelligence.
Are you sure about that, Sarge?
Some criminal intelligence that he'd like to share with the rest of the relief.
First time for everything, then.
I think you've got a video you want to show us, Rod.
Yeah.
I'll have your home once again, Rod.
Where's the TV?
I thought you'd check the equipment, Rod.
I did.
We have excellent audiovisual facilities here.
Where?
June?
I've got no idea, sir. I mean, it's hard to keep track of equipment. There's never anything here when you want it.
Perhaps DC Skase can brief the officers without his video.
Yes, yes, of course. Rod, get on with it.
OK, we've had some dev-noms and sleepers come back into Sunhill, but... I wanted to show you what they look like. And
can't you just describe them?
Well, perhaps you could draw them on a piece of paper for us.
I'll circulate some mugshots later, sir.
Was Terry Duggar one of the dev noms?
No.
Well, it's just that you said he'd been seen on Gasson Street.
Dave, I'm trying to keep that quiet.
Well, surely the whole point of local intelligence is to share it with us so that we know what we're looking for when we're out on the street.
That's typical of CID, keep that information to themselves. No, actually, Tony, it's not information, it's just a possible sighting of a... one individual, that's all.
Who you want to nick yourself?
Well, I had no idea Terry Duggan was back in Sunhill. I know of a couple of places he might be staying.
Oh, well, if you tell us where, Paul, we can look for them.
Right.
No, please, just keep your hands off Duggan, all right?
So you do want to nick him for yourself?
Perhaps you should move on to the next item, eh, Sarge? As you can see, we're pretty informal here. So just ask any questions you feel.
I'd like to ask a question. Read the nature of shared information. You often talk about the different attitude towards intelligence that CID seem to have compared with uniform. Do you have general discussions?
Well, we might do, Sarge, if we ever got the chance to discuss anything with CID.
What do you mean? Isn't this a normal parade?
No, it's not normal. Sergeant Ackland is usually a lot quicker than this. Aren't you, Sergeant?
What is it?
How did that happen? I honestly don't know.
Well, you must have stuffed something down there. What is it?
I promise you, Sergeant, I didn't do a thing.
Then how comes it's blocked?
I'm sorry, I don't know. I'm not a plumber.
You were in number 2, weren't you?
Yes, the toilet got blocked there as well, and I don't know what you're thinking, but I promise you, I don't know how that happened either. Do I look like a troublemaker?
I don't know.
They come in all shapes and sizes.
Anyway, shall we go? Superb. When he went, where's the TV?
Dave?
Thanks a lot.
For what?
No, I suppose you didn't have anything to do with the missing TV, did you?
The DIU is not my responsibility.
I think you'll find it's Mr. Meadows.
He didn't look too pleased with the way things went in there, did he?
No, I wonder why.
Well, let's hope that Rodney doesn't get a bollocking, eh?
Hey, calm down.
What's your problem?
I'm driving it.
What?
That so-called low-mileage saloon you sold me. It's a pile of crap and you knew it when you took my money.
That's why you tried to stitch me up in there, because of the car?
I don't consider we're even yet, Rodney, so you better watch your back.
Get off of me! Get your bloody hands off!
What is happening here?
What the hell do you think you're playing at?
May I remind you, this is a police station. Not a place for arguments and violence. At least not between officers.
You all right?
I'm fine, thank you.
Jolly good.
It's not often people are this kind to me. I've experienced a lot of harsh treatment in my life.
Have you?
I react very badly to cruelty. But deep down, I'm a good man. If you're nice to me, I'm nice to you.
Well, that's nice.
Anything particular you want me to do with this?
Thank you, sir.
Is that a prisoner?
Yes, sir. Michael Haslam, indecent exposure.
Why isn't he in a cell?
We're full up.
Well, it doesn't look like it to me.
Well, two of the cells are out of action. Toilets are flooded.
Well, he can't be sitting there when the inspection starts, and they'll be here any minute.
He won't be any bother, sir. He's just a sad little man with a few problems.
Yeah, well, you'll have a few problems if he's not moved back into a cell.
With all due respect, sir...
Just hold it there, Matthew. I know what with all due respect means, and I'm not in the mood for backchat.
Do I have to remind you that I'm the custody officer?
Don't give me that, Sergeant. Not today. I want the flasher back in a cell.
You've no right to tell me what to do in this area.
All right, I'm sorry, Matthew, but not now, please.
Gary.
You called?
Get them up and clean up number two.
Oh, Sarge, do I have to?
Take a wild guess.
Right, I'll get them up.
Michael. OK.
Where are we going?
Back into your cell for a while.
What? I can't. It's filthy. You know I'm claustrophobic. You
just... Oh, no! Come on.
No!
Michael.
No!
Yes! Come on!
Don't make me go back in there, please!
Get off the... Hurry up, Matthew, they're coming! Nuts. Get in there!
Get off me! Get off me! You let go of my arm! I'm not going back in a cell, do you hear me?
You go whatever we tell you, mate. Now get in there!
No! Yes!
Get in!
Yes!
Get the panic
strip! No!
Need a hand, Tom!
Just a finger!
Is this a bad time?
Oh, yes, can I help?
Good afternoon. Good afternoon to you, sir. David Quinnan, please. Shall I wait over there?
No, hang on. You'd like to speak to PC Quinnan?
Yes, please. Tell him Nicky Newman's here.
I can't. Well, he's out and about at the moment. Would you like to come back later or leave a message?
No, this is very urgent. I must see him immediately.
Well, can you tell me what it's about?
I'm sorry, no. David says I must only speak to him. I am his snout. He's and his alone.
Did the prisoner hurt himself?
Unfortunately not, sir. But I've called the FME anyway, because he's a head case.
And where exactly was Mr. Conway when this was happening?
Lending a hand, sir.
You got a jailer. Why did you need help from Mr. Conway?
We didn't, and I tried to remind him of my responsibilities as a custody officer. Should we talk to the officer? The thing is, I think Mr. Conway was in a bit of a state over this area inspection. He was down here nearly every 10 minutes during the early term.
Doing what?
Checking the records, double-checking the review times. Like I say, I think he was in a bit of a state.
Would you say that this damage was due to his interference?
Well, obviously, I'm not going to point the finger at Mr. Conway. But we do seem to manage most days without losing basins off the wall.
Yes. Well, I think I'd better have a word with Mr. Conway. I'll get out of your hair, Matthew.
Thank you, sir.
Sarge, guess who wants to use the toilet?
Let him cross his legs.
Afternoon, Matthew.
Blimey, that was quick.
You were lucky I was passing. Sounds like you've got a bit of a tricky one.
Just a bit. Went bananas when we tried to lock him up.
Did he do that all by himself?
Like a man possessed. Needs to be sectioned, if you ask me. Well, he's calmed down a bit since then.
Yeah, I'll be with you in a minute. I'm on my way.
Rich. It's Nicky Newman.
Yeah.
What, has he come in to see me?
Yeah, he has. I was going to put a call out, but, I got a bit busy.
Well, I can see.
What are you doing now?
Rich, I could have gone out the back. If anybody asks for me, you find me.
It's all right, all right. He's a good snout, is he?
Oh, he's the best. Got his finger on the pulse and his ear to the ground.
You never guess.
If there's a bigger issue you know about, now's the time to tell me.
Well, I didn't know about any fight, sir. I thought Rod and Dave were
mates. There's no underlying grudge. No running dispute between officers that I don't know
about. No, of course not, sir. But with all due respect, perhaps you're being a little overdramatic.
Am I?
It was just a scrap between two young men over a second-hand car. It happens every day in the real world.
Well, I hope you're right, Derek. I get very depressed when officers under my command don't realise we're all fighting on the same side. You might remind Ron's case of that, Jack.
Oh, I will, sir. I'll be seeing him later to talk about a number of issues.
Good. Right. Thank you. Oh, Derek. If you've got a moment longer, perhaps we could discuss your part in this custody suite fiasco.
Check on your computer or your radio. You'll find Austin's on the run.
We're talking about the same Austin, Ken Austin. Got 10 years for armed robbery.
That's the fella. Went to hospital this morning for some kind of scan. He's escaped.
Why now, could he? There'd be screws all over the place.
And not where they do the x-rays. It's dangerous. I just heard he's done a runner and he's heading home to Sunhill. Check with Scotland Yard.
Wait here.
I'll be back in uniform before I get any chance of promotion.
Would that be such a bad thing?
Are you trying to be funny? I'm behind this desk enough as it is. If I was back in uniform, the only time I'd get out would be for crowd control.
Well, to be community leaders.
That's supposed to make me feel better. You know the worst thing? The thing that worries me most about leaving CID?
What?
They'd have to get me a haircut.
Dave?
Sergeant, I just got a lead about an escaped prisoner, Ken Austin.
Oh, yeah, I've heard that name.
Well, I checked with Yankee Romeo. He did a runner from a hospital on their ground this morning. Now my snout thinks he's coming to Sunhill.
Your snout reliable?
He's never been wrong before.
What's this?
Dave thinks he knows where an escaped prisoner might be hiding, sir.
Really? Tell me more.
Well, the prisoner's name's Ken Austin. I come across him on the Farley estate.
Is that where he's hiding?
No, no, he's got a girlfriend, lives on Emily Way. My snout reckons he's gone there.
And why would your snout reckon that?
Well, because he spends most of his time propping up the bar at the Pike's Head. A lot of Austin's old mates drinking there and they were talking about his girlfriend.
What, even though your snout was listening?
Well, he's not the sort of bloke you worry about. He looks harmless. Actually, he just looks drunk.
Do you know the exact address in Emily Way?
Number 9, flat 2.
Right.
Just give us a moment, will you please, Dave?
Sure.
Before we deal with that business, I'd just like to say thank you, June. I heard about the parade.
I don't know what you're talking about, sir.
No, of course you don't, but thanks anyway. Not that I'm ahead of Jack Meadows at this moment in time.
Oh, sir.
No, Mr. Brownlow thinks I'm responsible for making a bit of a mess in custody.
I'm sorry to hear that, sir.
Yes, got me knuckles wrapped. But it doesn't matter. The plumbing can wait.
Of course it can, sir.
Yes. We've got a prisoner to catch. We'll go in 5 minutes. Has everybody got a vest to wear?
Do you think we'll need them, sir?
There'll be knives in the kitchen, Polly. I'm not taking any chances. Dave, you get the enforcer. You'll be with me and Sergeant Acker.
Sir.
Right, the entrance to flat 2 is at the back, so you and Polly go through the front, George.
Sir.
Sir.
Michelle, you stay here, right?
Sir.
Let me appear, Arjun, please.
Sir.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra Oscar 5-4 receiving.
Just a moment, please.
Can I ask you to stand by, sir, unless it's urgent? We're all on the phone at present. Thank you.
Can you give me a description of
now, madam, you were saying?
Oh, hello, Andrew. Come in, take a seat.
Sorry, I'm late, sir. I had a meeting at the town hall.
That's all right. Mr. Conway with you?
No, sir.
Well, as we should make a start.
Right, sir. As you know, the full report of our inspection will be made
Sierra
available.
Oscar 5-4. Go ahead with your message.
Thanks, Bob.
Is that Mr. Conway?
I think so.
9 Emily Way, flat 2. All units listen out in case we shout for assistance. Over.
All received.
What's he doing down there?
I have no idea, sir.
You don't know what's happening? But your chief inspector's involved in some kind of situation that might require backup.
Chief Inspector Conway doesn't always keep me up to speed.
I get the impression that Mr. Conway's a very hands-on chief inspector.
Nothing wrong with that.
If it doesn't impede the officers he's supposed to be commanding.
Quite. Would you mind finding out exactly what Mr. Conway is up to, Andrew? Perhaps lend a hand? Or take over?
Right, sir.
This is almost 6 weeks old. I want it finished by tonight.
Sir.
This one. I want them all finished by the end of tomorrow, otherwise you're going to be grounded for a month.
Right.
Chris, you fancy a drink?
Good idea. All right, Deacon. Yeah. All right, mate, slow down.
Come on, Chris.
Kane Austin, we're on our way. Go.
Rod, come with us.
Well, where are we going?
The DA had a call from one of his snouts. He told him that he knows where Kane Austin's hiding out.
Who?
He's doing 10 years for armed robbery.
Well, he was till he did a runner.
Where is he now?
Emily Way.
And the three of us are going to nick him.
From Sierra Oscar 3, we're knocking on the door now, over.
Received.
Who is it?
Police, open the door.
It's the police are here! Leave him alone!
Open up, Dave.
He's got my kids! He's got my little boy!
Is Ken Austin in there?
He's just grabbed them and get him out of there!
Where's he taking the boy?
Upstairs, the bathroom at the end!
Has he got a weapon?
Oh, please, just get him out of there! Don't let
him out of here, please!
No, I'll talk to him, try and make him see sense. Get her out of here, right, and tell everybody what's going on. Nobody else upstairs.
Let's go downstairs. We'll let them deal with it.
I'm taking a pander over to Emily Wadeboro. What's the latest?
It's all quiet, sir.
Mr. Conway hasn't cocked it up yet.
Is that what you were expecting, sir?
You heard about the damage in custody.
That was hardly his fault, was it?
He shouldn't have been there. He should stick to what he's good at.
Which is what, sir?
Good question, Bob.
Ken, can you hear me? I'm Derek Conway from Sunhill Police Station. Chief Inspector. I was hoping you'd come out and talk to me. Ken?
I'm not coming out. I'd rather kill myself.
No, Ken. Look, I want you to bring the child out and talk to me about what's happened. Now, will you do that?
You've got to be joking.
How is the boy?
He's all right. For now. Don't you try and get me.
I won't try and do anything, Ken. I just want to talk to you.
Yeah. Well, what about all the other coppers? What are they doing? Tooling up in the backyard?
No. But you don't have to worry about anybody else. I'm in charge here. Nobody does anything without my permission.
Oh, yeah. Well, you tell them to get away from here. Go on.
Mommy! Hey, you just relax. I'll go and tell my colleagues to go. Then it'll be just us, all right?
Don't you leave the flat. Just shout through the door. And when you've told them to go, shut the door and put the bolt on.
Okay.
Anyone comes in here after that, I kill the kid.
What uniform do you have?
Did your snout tell anybody else about this?
No, Gov.
Sir.
What's going on?
Mr. Conway's up there now talking to an escaped prisoner, Ken Austin.
Yeah, I know what he's called. But how did you know he was here?
I can't really talk about that now, sir.
Right, let's sort this out.
What's happening?
It's all right, they're trying to sort it out.
So, where's Mr. Conway?
He's still inside the flat. I can't let you in there, sir.
What?
Well, the suspect's got a little kid held hostage. He says he's going to kill him if we try to get inside.
So when does the cavalry arrive? You have called for backup, haven't you?
Mr. Conway's doing this by himself.
Not anymore, is he?
I'm sorry, sir. I can't let you in there. I've got my orders.
Whose orders?
Mr. Conway's.
Look, I'm going to go up there, have a closer look, and I'm going to call for assistance.
But if Austin sees or hears you, the kid might get hurt. So, look, why don't you just wait back there, sir? Sir, please.
It'll be all right, don't worry.
You keep saying don't worry when he's got a gun.
What did you say?
He's got a pistol and automatic.
Why didn't you say this before?
You should have got Sammy out of there.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra Oscar 3, urgent message.
Go ahead, June.
Flat 29 Emily Way, the suspect is believed to have a handgun. Can we have an ARV now, please?
Repeat, ARV needed at flat 29 Emily Way.
Received.
What are you doing?
Turn him round.
Why?
To get to Emily Way.
What for?
What do you mean, what for?
There's a gun, Tone. What are we supposed to do?
I don't know. Pick up the pieces, mop up the blood. There'll be something for us to do.
Oh, great.
Sierra Oscar 3 from Sierra Oscar. Receiving.
Go ahead, Ben.
You've got Trojan 631 assigned.
Received.
They need SO-19, not a couple of plods.
Everything all right, Sergeant?
Not really, Tony, no. Mr. Conway's up there talking to the suspect. He doesn't know he's got a gun.
Well, unless Austin's told him or shown him.
We've got to make sure he knows and he hasn't got a PR or a phone.
He's locked the door. He says he's going to top the kid if anyone tries to open it.
Look, why don't I go up there and put a note through the letterbox and get yourself shot?
Actually, that's not such a bad idea.
What?
Well, somebody's got to do something.
Might as well be you then, look.
But you be careful and very, very quiet. Try and get Mr. Conway's attention without the suspect hearing you. Get him to the door and then either tell him about the gun or pass him a note, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, okay, Sarge.
You go with him, Dave.
Hey?
Go.
Sierra Oscar 3 from Trojan 631, receiving?
Yeah, go ahead.
Could we have direction for your location, please?
What?
We're on the Gadsden Road heading west.
Yeah, you want to do a right into Foundry Road and then straight across into Ellis Square, yeah?
Talking to someone.
He may not be your son, Ken. But what's the boy ever done to you?
I don't want to kill him.
Well, don't then. It's as simple as that. Just let the boy out and he can go back to his mother and then we can sort this mess out. What do you say?
You nearly had me, then you...
Oh, my God!
What's he doing up there?
Trojan 631 from Sierra Oscar 3. A shot's been fired. Quick as you can, please.
Sierra Oscar 3 from Sierra Oscar. Do you need an ambulance, June?
I don't know. We can't get to Mr. Conway. Stand by.
Mr. Conway! Can you hear me?
Ken! Ken, you OK? Is the boy all right?
He's bleeding.
Did you shoot him, Ken? For God's sake! Open the door, let's get him to hospital.
Fell over, cut his head. He's all right, ain't you, Sammy?
Come on, son. Get downstairs. Where's the gun?
On the floor.
Get out here! You have to search
you.
Yeah,
no. You're gonna nick me as well, ain't you?
You just be grateful you haven't been shot.
In the upstairs bathroom. There was a shot just now. He's got our Inspector Conway.
Come on. Come on. Just wait there. Don't move.
His mum's back there in the panda. Go and see your mum, eh?
Sir? It's okay, June. Everything's under control. There's a handgun in the bathroom. Tony, go with him, will you?
Sir? Sammy!
Sammy!
Sammy, darling!
Oh, baby, you're right. Are you all right, Sammy?
Absolutely, yeah. I've got one prisoner for the nick. And one young boy for the hospital. It's only a couple of stitches, I think.
That is a bit worried there, Derek.
Did I? Can't think why.
Sir?
Yeah, before you ask, I'm fine.
I can see that. I was going to ask why I wasn't informed of this situation. I was made to look like an idiot in front of the area inspection team.
Well, that makes three of us.
So that's how he did it. A vest in that cell and a jumper in this. Payback time.
Do you mind? I'm on the loo.
What, trying to block it again?
Sarge, we got customers.
Is this your prisoner, sir?
He is until I've booked him in, yes, Matthew. Luke, go and find D.I. Deakin. Tell him I want to hand this prisoner over to C.I.D. before they go to the pub.
Sir.
Meadows. Oh, hello, Joe. How are you? Good news or bad news?
Oh, Derek. I understand you were involved in a hostage situation.
Yes, sir. Not a bad result, as it happens. One escaped prisoner recaptured, nobody seriously injured.
More by luck than good judgment, I gather.
Yes, well, perhaps you've been talking to the wrong people, sir.
Possibly. Well, I'd like to hear about it. Tomorrow. Good night.
Good night.
Better make that a larger one. I've got some bad news for you.
What?
He didn't make it through the paper sift. But don't worry. Neither did I.
Are you sure about this?
Yeah, I got a friend at area. He rang me, saw a list of the results. He also saw your application form.
And?
Section F, OCU comments. Guess which box he ticked.
According to Brownlow, you cannot with confidence be promoted to the rank of superintendent at this time. He stitched you up, Derek, and he didn't have the guts to tell you.
Got a problem, Derek?
If you get out of the car, I'll tell you, sir.
Well?
You bastard.
What did you call me?
You heard me, because I said it to your face. I didn't write down what I think of you on a piece of paper.
What exactly is the problem, Derek?
You know bloody well, my application for promotion. You said I wasn't good enough. You didn't tell me we were going to do that.
Derek.
Well, you should have, because that's the least you owe me.
I had to give my professional opinion about your abilities.
You didn't have any problems with my abilities when you wanted some on-call cover, did you? I've lost count of the times I've been acting superintendent just so you could have the weekend off or an early night.
And I've always been very grateful.
I didn't want your gratitude. I wanted your support, but I never got it, did I? Every single time I've gone for promotion, you've been there to block me. Now, I was never good enough for you, was I? Wrong attitude, wrong image, wrong face. Well, I'm sorry if I've got the wrong face, but at least I've only got one of them. I should move your car, sir, actually. You're blocking somebody else. Pub.
Yeah. Maybe just the one.
If I had got shot, do you think Brownlow would have come to my funeral?
Bound to. He'd have given a narration. No finer officer than Derek Conway. Great loss to the police service. I couldn't stand the little like.
You know I won't be acting super anymore, don't you? If Brownlow asks, I'll tell him to stuff it.
It's a new you, Derek.
It is. No more Mr. Nice Guy.
Farewell, Chief Inspector Nice Guy.
Do you want a lift?
Yeah, all right. Cheers, mate.
You know the worst thing about all this, don't you? Having to tell the wife.
Will she be disappointed?
Jack, you can't even begin to imagine. Sandra's always taken my rejections worse than me. Do you know, she had a word with Brownlow about it when I received my long service medal. If I was him, I'd be scared of her.
I didn't tell my wife I was having a go. I didn't want her to get her hopes up.
I thought you'd get through that paper sift, no problem. It wasn't that late turn parade that counted against you.
No, there wasn't time to get word back on that. The black spot was put on me years ago. There's still a few twats at area that think I'm not squeaky clean.
That's forgotten now, isn't it? Surely.
Well, you'd hope so, wouldn't you? I've served my sentence as DTI. I want to get back to being superintendent again. I deserve it. I deserve to be back there.
Well, your turn will come, Jack. As for me, I'd be amazed if Brownlow doesn't transfer me. I would. I'd transfer me if I was him and I talked to myself the way I did.
Do you want another drink? It's my round.
What's all that about?
It's trouble, Brian.
Well, you know what we've got to do, don't you? Let us not forget the statement of common purpose of the Metropolitan Police Service. To uphold the law firmly and fairly, to prevent crime and keep the Queen's peace.
Yeah, in other words, to find another pub.
Exactly.